Well, this is Josh with a how-to disassembly of the Ithaca m37. They made about 2 million of these things, and they're still making some. This is the way you would disassemble one of the ones that does not have interchangeable barrels. It's quite possible that the newer models, this one's 57 years old, would be different. So don't quote me on that. This is the old style. You get your mag tube cap screwed on here. That's what holds the barrel together. Sometimes they're very tight. If you're lucky, yours has holes in it like mine, so you can throw a Allen wrench through it. You will have to pump the action. I didn't say that, but it should be obvious. Push the barrel off. So now you can maintenance the chamber, the breech, obviously all the parts you could have maintenance before. You can also test the function of the gun safely because there's no way to hold it in place to fire it. It'll be safer, and you can see how it cycles. We got the mag tube cap here. This one was 50 years old before you had to change the springs. Apparently they use universal or generic springs, so don't worry about having to buy an Ithaca one. This one's for a Remington and it works perfect. You'll have to quite possibly get a different one if you have a longer tube. This one is 4 shots, 2¾ inch. I don't know if I said that already. This is all of the maintenance that your average user would have to do. If you have a problem with the stock, you're probably not going to be able to get a new one, so just get one of those rubber things that goes over the end. If the stock for you is too long, then you have a problem. You'll have to change the stock. Probably have a gunsmith make it for you. Possibly you could buy it, but if you have an old model, who knows. Okay. This is as far as the average user should go. Any further is going to be armorer / gunsmith only. So you've been warned. To take the action apart, we got a little screw that notches into a big screw, another one on the other side, and this guy goes right through the middle. Shouldn't matter, they're identical on the other side, so you don't actually have to keep track of that, per se. When you do reassemble this, if you are going this far, I don't recommend gluing them. One, they're usually pretty tight to begin with. Two, you don't need to. The gun doesn't recoil enough to damage that. The thing to keep track of is how tight your stock is, because this one is cracked, and it doesn't appear to be damaged too much in any other way, so the reason it is cracked is because it wasn't tight properly. Two-piece stocks are really common for that, especially with high-pressure loads. Not sure why, but this stuff all appears to be magnetized. I've never magnetized any of these tools, so I'm not sure why that is, but it might not be magnetized. Okay, so a total of 5 screws. That guy goes back. Okay, here's where the gun gets kind of interesting. There's a small rail, a little small for the gun. On the bottom here, that's how it slides back in. Once you're done tearing it apart, we can get to most all the pieces here. Careful of that piece. I wonder if it fell out before. Yeah, hopefully you just start hurling back in if yours falls out. Okay. Now you can further clean any of the other more complex parts of the gun. I don't recommend going any further than this. There's really no point. Gun probably would never even have to go this far, just in case you have to do something with the stock beyond the normal, or if you have one that's extremely old and you just want to cherry it out. Now we're going to go back together. Hopefully this part doesn't give me a problem. I've never had one with it before, but it never came out before. Okay, when you put it back together, you're probably going to have to throw a screwdriver in there and line the holes up. For whatever reason, it doesn't align the holes for you. Try to make sure you put it back together the way you took it apart. That makes it a lot easier the next time you do it. You don't have to watch the video. If there's any detail that I might have missed here, or didn't like the way I did it, I'm sure there's plenty of other
assembly videos on the Ithaca m37.
It's a great gun. The military used it from the 50s. Somewhere in the 60s where they switched over to the M870. It's still used by special ops guys. It's extremely reliable because it only has one port for eject and load. Less stuff for maintenance, less stuff to get crap in, especially in jungle warfare, like say in Vietnam, which you use them when they actually change over to the M870. One of the older models like this one had a 2¼-inch maximum chamber. Apparently it was an all-aluminum receiver, and this is an extremely lightweight model. They did make, or do make now, 3-inch. And that screw goes back in. Now when you're tightening this, really important to remember, there's little holes on the four sides of it. That hole has to line up with this one so that the screw that holds this screw in place can be screwed in. It's really weird, I don't know what it's called, but here it is. Bam, little screw. This one is kind of a pain, actually. All it really does is hold the other screw in place. It doesn't even screw in very far. Like I said, I've never had anything on this gun fall apart. Except for that piece that fell out when I flipped it over. I guess that's the slide guide rod. Yeah, rod. Slide guide rod, yeah. Something like that. Alrighty. Screws are through. Apparently the slide's working fine. Follower, spring, don't bother compressing it unless yours is excessively long, no point in messing around with it. Thread around all the ways, back to back, barrel. Anytime you tear a gun apart, there's two things you need to make sure. One, that the action works. All the buttons still work. Safety. Safety's now on. Doesn't do anything. Slide works fine. Funny thing that most people don't know, this gun actually has a decocker. You do not have to dry fire. Never had any problem with it, but if you did, back to slide back a little tiny bit, pushing the little lever down here. Slide forward. Pull back. That's a decock. The gun is no longer in fire position. This gun is safe to carry with 5, 4 in the mag tube and 1 down the pipe. The safety is pretty light. It's never failed on me. So that's all depends on how safe you feel
turned around.
A loaded cocked gun. If you have an M37 and you want to know how old yours is, you can actually go to Ithaca's website. They have a thing with all of them all the way back to like 1920 or something crazy like that, whenever they started making them. This one's from the 1950s. We'll go ahead and clean it up later. That's it.